All right, so thanks for tuning in, folks. So today we're going to do an overview of what's new in the Pega Infinity 23 edition of the Pega Customer Decision Hub. So my name is Matt Nolan, and I run product marketing for the customer decisioning team here at Pega. And today we're going to talk to our Vice President of Product Management, Shoel Perelman. Now, before we jump in, we realize that not everybody has the same like background or understanding of some really complex topics like artificial intelligence, like real-time decisioning, customer engagement. So we're going to get everybody on the same page and talk a little bit about what's been going on out there in the market. So as most people in the corporate world have probably heard over the last, say, 6 months or so, there's been this absolute like explosion in conversations around what's called generative AI, right? Which is a form of machine learning that's able to create really high quality text and videos and images and other forms of content and do it very, very quickly. So you've probably heard or played with an implementation of it like ChatGPT or Bard or DALL-E, like systems like those, where you can ask the software really nuanced stuff and get really robust answers, or use those things to create very personalized graphics, images, like they do things like mix Nicolas Cage with Darth Vader, put them together, intriguing stuff, right? Now, Shoel, I know that your team has been very focused on generative AI, especially recently, but kind of start at the beginning for me, man. Like, why is this whole concept so compelling for our clients?
It's compelling because the core value proposition of CDH is that it generates lift by being able to test lots of different content and not just do A-B testing to figure out what the winner is, but to really figure out what is the best thing to say to each person, right? Everybody's going to be different. That's where the whole one-to-one ethos comes from. But in order for that to be fueled, we need lots of really good variations of content. And you know, one of the barriers has been that content teams just can't come up with enough of these different variations for CDH to be able to test. And that's where Gen AI really shines, because it's great at doing exactly that.
Okay, it makes sense. If you've got dozens of channels and hundreds of conversations and billions of interactions a year, you need an awful lot of content. Scaling content to that is hard. So I hear a lot of talk generally in the industry about what generative AI can do, right? And like anything new, I think companies they're building apps, they're trying to use it to do everything, like even stuff maybe it isn't really suited for. Now, you're in charge of development for the Customer Decision Hub, which uses Next Best Action to kind of orchestrate customer engagement across hundreds of huge enterprises across the world. Like, you know, you're talking Wells Fargo, T-Mobile, State Farm. Like, what role do you see generative AI playing in this kind of one-to-one customer engagement space, if you will?
Yeah, I think, you know, long-term, there's lots of opportunities that we're pursuing around being able to meet marketers where they are, be able to make things easier for them to understand in their own language. But I think really the low-hanging fruit where I expect to see a lot of value early on is being able to use it to generate all those different variations of being able to say the same thing in different ways. So there's a fellow named Cialdini. He's come up with these principles of persuasion. You know, there's the principle of authority, which is you should buy this product because I said so. There's the principle of social proof, which is, did you know that all your friends are using this product, right? So we don't know which of those principles will work for each person, but by using Gen AI to infuse the message with those principles, we can quickly generate 10 different variations of the same call to action using those different principles. I think that's going to be huge.
And that would have taken clients a long time by themselves doing that manually. And then you can use Next Best Action to kind of, if you will, learn which ones are, you know, work best for each customer. So that's great context, but let's dive into this release a little bit. So how will clients actually see generative AI represented in Infinity 23 specifically? And I'm sure the release, you know, it's not all about Gen AI, right? So what are some of the other new capabilities we'll see? Can you kind of highlight them for us?
Yeah, I guess I'll first answer your first question. Where does it show up? So the answer is it shows up as part of our change management process, which is really built on top of one-to-one operations manager, which of course is commercially available through what we call the one-to-one strategy optimization bundle. And so it'll be another use case within one-to-one ops manager, which is we have an approval for you. We always feel that humans have to be in the loop. It's never going to just go off and go do something and go live with it, right? It's going to present it to the humans and say, hey, here's what I came up with for you. Do these fit your brand principles or your brand voice? And you would approve them. But some of the other things that I'm really excited in this release are a feature called one-time actions. And that's really been about making the concept of one-to-one more easily approachable in use cases where they're not evergreen actions, right? What I mean by that is, sure, if you have an action that would be about, hey, could I interest you in a new handset? That's something that would always be applicable. But there may be a message like, hey, we have a one-time promotion going on for the next week, right? That's something that traditionally in traditional campaign marketing, you would have had to come up with a campaign and run it, right? We want to embrace those use cases as well. And so that's what one-time actions is about. One of the other things that I am excited about, it's a little more technical, is something that we call bring your own key encryption. And so that's really about knocking down one of the barriers to adoption for Pega Cloud.
Okay, and I want to go through each one of those with you. So let's dive into the intelligent treatment stuff a little bit. So for the people watching that actually went to PegaWorld this year, right? This is a feature you likely saw demonstrated live, like in the Innovation Hub, where we showcased how generative AI can help marketers create and edit multiple versions of treatments like Shoel talked about and make them feel kind of really compelling for the customer, right? Give you a lot of variation. But Shoel, like, how does that work under the covers? Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah. So we've built prompts. We've done the prompt engineering and we've baked those into the change request process. So when you ask for a new treatment, right? One of the variations is you ask for a set of new treatments, in which case CDH will take the prompt, it will substitute in maybe any special instructions that you gave it, and it will call out to a GPT provider, a cloud generative AI provider. We're pre-integrating it on Pega Cloud. So if you're using CDH on Pega Cloud, you don't have to buy anything new. This will just work. And then it'll go through the workflow process, present it to you, and you know your marketers will get to approve it. There's another variation where it will look for opportunities. It'll look for actions that don't have enough treatments and proactively go and generate these proposals and ask you if you're okay with them.
So you either give it some directional insight that generates them for you, or in some context, it will actually come to you and say, hey, you need more in this for this specific action or this specific type of circumstance. Okay, love that. Now, I know the next one to me, I'm a marketing guy, right? So this one might not be as flashy, but I know it's really foundationally solid. And it's really something that clients have been wanting and needing. So talk to me about the one-time actions. Like, what are those and how do they actually work? Because I think this is very unique to the concept of next best action. And I think it's one that we should probably talk through a little bit.
Yeah. So what we did is, you know, we listened to client feedback and we heard that there are certain types of use cases that just don't naturally fit that well into the one-to-one paradigm where I'm going to create an action and I'm going to know which checkbox to check. For example, if it's a regulatory communication, I would have to know that there's a certain feature in the product that will only deliver it once and only once, right? So what we've done is we've created a screen that has a bunch of different buttons that you can click on. We call them tiles that explicitly say, click on this one if you want to create a one-time regulatory communication. Click on this one if it's a product promotion, right? When you click that button, it will walk you through selecting all the right checkboxes to implement what you need to get the outcome you're looking for.
So it makes it extreme. Like if you think of an evergreen campaign as one that runs over and over and over again, these are actions that might only be used once, but they're still of extreme value in a lot of cases. Like during the pandemic, when there were a lot of times a communication that simply had to go out to the base, but it could be difficult to get that up and running through the whole evergreen piece. So you've kind of built a way to get through this fast, if you will, and in a clean way and in a templated kind of way.
Exactly. And it'll do the cleanup afterwards. So after you run it, those aren't necessary anymore. It'll clean them out of the system.
Okay, awesome. So it feels like you've also made some real investments in usability in the Customer Decision Hub. That's being one of them. And that's obviously huge. And it aligns with everything we're trying to do with generative AI. But you talked about what you called, and I like the term, you said bring your own key encryption. Like, what is that exactly? Why do organizations need it? Why is it important?
So I'll just step back and say, you know, for a while, we've been pretty vocal that I believe, the best way to deploy CDH and use it is on Pega Cloud. That's the gold standard. We operate it, we run it, we will scale it and look after it and so on, right? But one of the barriers that's come up is sometimes clients have their own data privacy regimes that prohibit them from putting customer data on somebody else's cloud, right? They want to control the encryption keys themselves. We've long had encryption, we encrypt everything, but Pegas hold on to those encryption keys. So what we're introducing now is for clients to be able to have their own encryption key store where they control it, CDH will point to it, And when a customer record needs to be decrypted in order to do engagement policy filtering, it'll decrypt it in that moment using the customer's key, do the filtering, and then we have no access to that customer profile in unencrypted form anymore sitting on our cloud.
So it really does help them maintain compliance with their own standards. And it basically makes everybody, it makes it a lot easier to kind of get that in and get it done inside of CDH. That makes sense to me. Okay. So talk to me a little bit about the future, right? Kind of where you're going with the product. Like, what's important for Pega? And like, where are you kind of planning to invest a lot of your time and resources as you move forward inside the product?
Yeah. So what I'm really excited about is going beyond meeting marketers where they are and actually taking work off of their plate. So an example of this would be, you know, in a well-functioning one-to-one system, you need some sort of governance to be able to make decisions about like, well, credit cards wants a bump, right? And mortgages wants a bump. Now, they'd be willing to negotiate to take their bumps at different times during the year, right? Today, there needs to be some sort of governance structure. A group of people need together and they need to negotiate and barter. Like, all right, you can bump up credit cards in September, but in April, we need to give more to, you know, to mortgages, let's say. So what I really see the system being able to do is being able to understand those different competing needs and be able to use the tools underneath the hood to come to the right optimal outcome. So for example, it might, rather than expecting a human to like run a simulation, see what that ends up doing to credit cards, right? If it's not quite enough, bump the simulations up enough. We want to be able to just build that into the software so it just does it. It really gets to that autonomous enterprise.
So it like, if I think about this the right way, what the system would really be doing is kind of running those simulations behind the scenes. Instead of a person going through and running this themselves, it's running them and then looking at the opportunity costs of the different investments they could make, and then ultimately recommend either making that change directly, maybe if it's like within parameters, or making recommendations to the people who are actually running the and controlling the system. This is what you should do to kind of achieve these outcomes. Is that kind of where you're going with that?
Exactly. Help them out.
Okay.
Take some of that work off of their plate.
Makes perfect sense, man. And I know so Shoel, that's exactly what I was looking for from this. Okay, folks, unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today. They're giving me the hook like they usually do because I talk way too much. So I just want to say thank you for watching. And for more information about Pega's Infinity 23 release, please visit the launch page on Pega Community. That's your home for everything you're going to need for Pega Infinity 23. For me and Shoel, thank you very much. And everybody have a great day.